Hello, I'm Dani. Welcome to the workshop. Today, in one of the groups that I'm a member, I had a really interesting question. One person decided to make a cabinet for his 3D printer in SolidWorks, and he also decided to use Weldments so he can create a cut list of the parts. But he faced one problem. No matter that he was marking an option in which description of weldment part should take its sizes, it was not working. Let's see his question, his problem, and what actually was the solution.
Good morning all. Everyone knows that having a terrace and not having a cupboard on it is like having homemade brandy and not having an empty whiskey bottle in which to serve it. This is how my problem with modeling in SolidWorks was born. I made a small test cabinet in SW, but I can't see its dimensions in the description in the weldment cut list. I googled, looked, but for people it works fine, but for me there is a computer error.
First, I have recreated the cabinet that he wanted to do. Then, of course, I created also a sheet in which we will place the different view sizes and our bill of materials. But to do so, first what we have to do, we go on the Weldments tab in SolidWorks and just hit Weldment. And no matter that's not standard use of Weldments, it's quite clever one, like using sheet metal to make cardboard boxes, which I was doing in the past. And do you know what else is actually not standard? To like the video when you enjoy it, because people often forget. So don't forget, give it a like now. Then, if we go in the sheet, we can place a cut list. However, once we place the cut list, we see that we have item number and quantity, but no description. So we go back to our cabinet and go to the properties of the document. Then on the Weldments tab, we will see that solid bodies can have a description with their thickness, their length, and their width. I will change it so the length is first and the thickness is last. The rest I will leave the same. But what happens now? We are going back to our drawing and nothing has changed. So this is exactly the problem our user has facing. So what was causing it? We have everything, but let's check again the property. So we go again in Weldments and what we see is that is written actually a bounding box properties. And we go back to our model and extend our cut list, and what we see here is that we don't have a single bounding box. When we don't have it, actually we cannot take the values. So what we are going to do now is we're adding a bounding box with right mouse button click. We are adding bounding box to each cut list item, and then it will take automatically the values that we want to show in the table. Once we have done that, we can go back to our drawing, and as you can see, now the description has plate and sizes inside instead of staying blank. In this video, it looks fast and easy, the solution, but actually I spent quite some time until I found out that what we're missing in this case is actually the bounding box. The thing is, you don't receive it by default when you go to Weldments. So what you have to do is, each part you want to be in the cut list, you have to create a bounding box. Then you can use this property which is taking the sizes. I hope you enjoyed this video and see you next time. Bye bye!